A very good evening to the august gathering present here. My sincere thanks to British Council for enabling us this beautiful platform to share our thoughts as to how this COVID scenario was handled in schools in a VUCA world. Well, I'm V.N. Chakravarti, Principal, Pragati Central School, Hyderabad. When there is that very fact that schools are going to be shut down for an indefinite period of time, the first thought that comes to our mind is, how is it that we are going to keep these kids actively, positively and productively engaged? We all know that kids are bundles of energy, and we all know that kids, when at home, quite often they do not listen to their parents. Therefore, a daily routine was designed and broadcasted to all the children right from wake up time to bedtime. They were given clear instructions as to what is supposed to be done at home. This gave a huge sigh of relief to all the parents. That besides, to ensure that this schedule is being followed, frequent follow-up calls were made by the teachers. They were there to ensure that the schedules were followed with these phone calls. Now, we also must understand that the health of the child has to be looked into, and therefore during the live online classes, a break of 5 to 10 minutes was designed to ensure that children bring immunity boosters to the live online class and have it in the presence of their classmates and teachers. This ensured the safety and well-being of the health of the children as well, which was very, very well received by the parents. Now, coming to the fact that there were many parents who had, you know, pay cuts as well as loss of jobs, it was definitely a worry to procure digital infrastructure. Therefore, we as a school ensured that we minimized this expenditure for the parents. If at all there was a parent with two kids, we asked the parent to manage with one gadget that they have, or even if they do not have, then the fact that we have designed video recorded lessons for every concept and uploaded on YouTube was readily available for them to follow the lessons whenever they have the father's gadget or the mother's phone with them. Now, this besides, there were some families with one gadget. So the senior the elder sibling who was in the senior class was allowed to log into the live online class, and the younger kid was asked to follow the video recorded lessons in the afternoon when the older kid was not having a class. This enabled children, both children, or maybe, you know, the families, ensure that learning continued. Now, when it comes to examinations, we know that it's always one slot for all children. But the families where there was only, you know, one gadget, we ensured that a separate question paper was made for the siblings and a separate slot was, you know, designed for them in the afternoons so that they also take up the examinations without any kind of a pause or hindrance. Now, when it comes to the frontline workers, you know, we must understand that the frontline workers, they were there for the community. So a set of teachers were given instructions to follow up with these, you know, children. So frequent phone calls were made for these children, you know, asking them whether they had their breakfast on time, lunch on time, as to what they've been doing. So that follow up was given to all the frontline workers, you know, children. And there was definitely huge appreciation for this as well. Now, coming to the fact that not just the kids, even teachers have to be, you know, looked after. Their well-being is very important, yes. And many schools, there were definitely, you know, pay cuts also, but teachers have not, you know, given up on their conviction to work. So for this, we in our school ensured that paid leave was granted to the teachers just in case there was any teacher who was affected with COVID, or even if there was a loss of loved one in the family, paid leave was granted to them. Now, this way the teacher felt that sense of belongingness, and they were there to take up any more, you know, any number of responsibilities to be there for the school and for the children. Now, coming to the fact that, you know, the teachers are at home, and most of the schools we have in the primary and mid school, we have women teachers who work. So they have to juggle between domestic work as well as, you know, school work. So it is also important to appreciate these teachers amidst the family members. So frequent calls are being made, particularly on birthdays, you know. Me as the principal, I make a call, a video call, a WhatsApp video call to the family. I wish the teacher in the presence of her family members, and ensure that I also extend my gratitude to the family that is supporting my teacher to do her best. Because any teacher We know it's not possible to do her best without the support of the family. So my gratitude is always there for the teachers and teachers' families for doing this marvelous work and being there for the children and parents. Now, all in all, I think this COVID year ensured that though there is a lot of uncertainty, there's a lot of unlearning and relearning. Apart from that, it is empathy that is actually keeping us together and ensuring that we are all, you know, enjoying that sense of contentment that we are there for one another and supporting each other. Besides that, I must also thank all the parents for their excellent support, collaboration and networking that they've been doing to be in line with the school initiatives. So I think with these few measures and many more, we tried to successfully handle the situation, and we are all definitely happy about what we have done and what we have been doing. Thank you very much.